It's my feel good breakfast show.
Call us on your cell phone.
Culinary hotline bling.
That can only mean.
See, as in again, as in top man on your feel good breakfast show. In case you didn't catch it, I was giving Anel and Zola a bit of a, you know, nyana nyana. They're going to be giving us lessons in cooking right now. We have opened up our lines.
Like, no!
083-913-3728. That number's on your screen right now. Give us a call and ask us any of your culinary conundrums as we continue right now. Taking a question that came from Facebook, Zola.
Yes.
It came from Cheryl Simon.
Yes.
Cheryl says, how do I make sourdough? I was thinking, just stare at it cross-eyed and it'll go sour. But no.
It takes a little more effort than that. Mm-hmm. Okay, so sourdough starter that we're going to show you how to make is basically a yeast or fermenting sort of mechanism.
Mm. English that never loved you.
Yes, that you sort of use the yeast that's airborne in your area.
Okay. The yeast that is airborne in your... Are you so saying there's yeast like right now?
Absolutely.
They said all absolutely around you.
So that's what I'm going to show you. So I'm going to show you how to make a sourdough starter. Cool. So sourdough starters is what's used to make artisanal bread, you know?
They serve in the restaurants, right?
They serve in the restaurant in like really great bakeries. Mm. They also make their own sourdough starter.
Right-o.
And also you can keep a sourdough starter forever.
Oh.
So pass it down to your kids, pass it, yeah, it's amazing.
Don't do that, it might rot.
No, it won't rot.
You mean the recipe, not the actual bread itself, right?
No, I'm talking about the sourdough starter, this mixture.
Okay.
So this is how you make it. Equal parts of water and flour, just normal, regular cake flour.
Just quickly, when you say equal parts of water and flour, right? So volume, 1 cup of water
to one cup
of flour.
Of flour, exactly. Right. So mix it together to form like a paste.
Yeah.
Okay. Then what you do is you take it outside and you just leave it.
And then the yeast from the airborne-ness will go...
Exactly, because the flour is a carb and has sugar in it, therefore the yeast can feed on it, so it eats it, basically,
yeah.
And causes carbon dioxide,
It's called oxidation.
Okay, that. And then it ferments, basically. And look at that, it turns into... a yeast mixture.
Yes.
And then when you're baking bread, instead of using that instant dry yeast that you buy, you'll use your sourdough starter.
Because
it has exactly the same properties. So you use a quarter cup of this to about 2 cups of flour.
Mm-hmm.
And to keep it forever, you have to feed your starter because it's alive, it's a living organism.
Okay.
It's like a cat or a dog, but just like from flour.
it just doesn't bark or do anything funny.
So you
like
can keep it in your fridge in a jar. Yeah. And every time you take a quarter cup out to use, you feed it with an equal quantity of flour and water.
Yeah.
So that it keeps eating and keeps growing. Listen, and stays alive.
We've got a call right now. Hester Alipa from Bloemfontein. Goeiemôre, Hester.
Goeiemôre.
Gaat het goed met jou?
Excuse. Met mij gaat het altijd goed. En als ik naar jullie kijk, dan krijg ik zoveel inspiratie.
Fantastisch. Wat is je vraag?
Ik heb niet een vraag. Nee, ik heb net een opmerking. Maybe lemon meringue.
Ja.
As ek lemon meringue maak, dan sif ek altyd 'n bietjie mesina op die sous of voor ek die meringue opsit. En dan wanneer ek hom sny, dan gly die meringue op nie af nie.
Dis
baie
interessant. Dankie daarvoor.
Ja.
Ek het nog nooit probeer nie.
Ja. Dis baie dankie. Sê hallo vir al die mense in Bloemfontein.
Dis koud.
It is bitterly go to the Free State. Like, it's crazy. But listen, we're going to continue with our culinary hotline. Lots of questions to answer. And of course, our lines do remain open. 083-913-3728. Hey,